As the schools opened for the third term yesterday, the leaders of the National Unity Platform urged school authorities to be considerate to parents and guardians as they pay school dues for their children. They spoke out during the weekly news conference held at their party office at Kavule in Kampala.
So we want to make an appeal to heads of schools. We know that especially private ones, yes, you have got bills to pay, but let's be considerate. Because the same economy squeezing you is the same economy squeezing the parents. Let's not be unreasonable.
During the same forum, the National Unity Platform President Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu revealed that the party will resume the national mobilization tour next month.
Allow me to remind you that we are soon going to resume our nationwide tour. We are coming to you wherever you are. We are going to reach you. So wait for us. Whether on crutches or not on crutches, we are coming.
Kyagulanyi is currently nursing wounds following a recent encounter with security forces which left him injured. The FDC Najana Nkumbi faction, through their party spokesperson John Kikonyogo, yesterday revealed to journalists a document they say it was from the Electoral Commission affirming their legitimacy as the rightful owners of the Forum for Democratic Change FDC party.
Twafunye ebaluwa eyavudde mu Electoral Commission ng'etukakasa nti amanya gonna bakyagalina bulungi era ebaluwa eyo.
Kikonyogo further urged the FDC Katonga faction to resort to approaches other than attempting to dissolve the FDC party.
Tujiwadde a week emu okuva olwaleero okutuuka ku Monday eya week eja bwe babanga ba promoter baffe bano be mulabako wano singa tebabawa forms wiki eno ezokuwandisa PFF ne Royal Blue Colour.
A further reveal that they are planning to hold a delegates conference to prepare for 2026 general elections. This comes at a time when the FDC Katonga faction has issued a one-week ultimatum to the Electoral Commission to register their newly proposed party or else take the commission to the courts of law. FDC Katonga applied to have the newly formed party registered, People's Front for Freedom, a move that was rejected by the Electoral Commission on the account of using an already gazetted party color for the FDC party. Donald Trump was the target of what the FBI said appears to be an attempted assassination at his golf club in West Palm Beach, Florida on Sunday, just 9 weeks after Republican presidential nominee survived another attempt on his life. The former president said he was safe and well, and authorities held the man in custody. President Joe Biden said that the U.S. Secret Service needs more personnel to perform its duties after a second apparent assassination attempt against the Republican election candidate Donald Trump. Biden added that, thank God the president's okay, following Sunday's incident in which the Secret Service opened fire on a gunman who was later arrested at Trump's golf course in Florida.
Thank God the president's okay. I think we got a full report so far. We're down there tonight. But one thing I want to make clear, the service needs more help. And I think the Congress should respond to their needs if they in fact need more services. So that's what we're going to be talking about. I think we need some more personnel. I think they're deciding whether they need more personnel or not. Are
you? Trump has blamed his election rival Kamala Harris and U.S. President Joe Biden after he was targeted in a second apparent assassination attempt, saying their rhetoric about him endangering democracy is to blame. Both Biden and Harris have denounced the apparent assassination bid. It was the latest jarring moment in a campaign year marked by unprecedented upheaval.